Hello, I'm Air Force Veteran Ed Ruckel from VeteranFacilitator.com. We're keeping veterans, family members, and caregivers informed is my passion. Today, I want to talk about how to update a legacy contact on Facebook. But before I do, I remind you, if you do like what I'm doing, please click on that subscribe button down below, and let's get started. Cake.com website. And to get to it, you just simply go into your address bar on your favorite browser and just type in joincake.com. Now, don't let this name confuse you. It has nothing to do with cake. It's a weird name. I know I'm confused when I first started with it as well. A lot of folks I talk to haven't a clue what it is. They think it has something to do with making bacon and eating a cake, but it doesn't. It's all about end-of-life stuff. I'll let you know how much you can trust this website. They are the largest end-of-life platform on the internet. They have 30 million viewers annually. That's nothing to sneeze at, okay? So here I am at the top. Now, I just finished a video dealing with this. It's called the navigation bar. And so you might refer to that one. It's out there on my archives. You can just take a look at it. So here I am on the page. And I just wanted to walk you through some of the high points, introduce you to the author, the contributor to the website. Now, these folks don't do videos, okay? They do just simply text. They have a great library of thousands of articles that have been written by experts. And I mean, I'm talking MDs, PhDs, BAs, and MBAs. I mean, I got all kinds of folks out there who really know what they're talking about. So it's trusted information. And here's an article that was done by Sherry Johnson. So I'm going to turn myself off here and give myself some breathing space. And so Sherry's written this article on how to update a legacy contact. Now, be honest, I've never heard of a legacy contact, never had to use one, so I didn't know what it was. But she explains it step by step how to update a legacy contact on Facebook. So I just want to walk you through a couple of the high points here. But if you come on down here, this over here is called the sidebar, and we had talked about it in that first video, where these are articles that appear in the library, and you just simply click on one of those, it'll take you right to that library article. But if you come on down here, it explains basically right off the bat what is a legacy contact. And it all has to do with the person who's responsible for getting information out to friends, families, and stuff, family members, etc., after you or your parents, pass away. That's it. That's basically what it is. And down here, you're going to see an interesting article. You know, some of these Facebook pages are 10, 12 pages long, and you don't want to be sifting there going up and down trying to get through these pages. So they've added jumps into each one of these pages. And if you just click on here, for example, here's one, what does a legacy contact do? Another one down there, how to create a legacy contact. Another one, how to update or remove the legacy contact. And to get that out to that article and to minimize your time on the website, you just simply click on it, okay? And it immediately goes down to that area of the page or on that the information appears. And if you want to get back up there, just click on the home button. That's on your digital numeric pad over there. It's the number 7 key. Just click on home and it goes right back up to the top. So that's one other nice feature about this website. Also, it has embedded links. Here's one on digital afterlife. Now, that takes you to another page. So if you click on that, okay, it'll bring you to that page. And to go back to it, you just simply click on your back arrow up here, all right? And it brings you right back to the point where you exited, where you did a jump or linked to that website page. Since this COVID thing, I want to tell you, a lot of stuff is happening digitally, and it's happening online. Like, for example, I just did a video on hosting a funeral online using Zoom. people are doing it because they can't travel or they can't get reservations or whatever the case may be, or the funeral homes have just minimized everything because we're still in a pandemic. It hasn't gone away, even though we're getting our shots, right? So a lot of good stuff that's coming around and about. Just come down through here and you're going to see another one down in here memorializing a Facebook account. So anyway, I just wanted to share that with you give you some of the high points, okay? This completes my presentation. From the information presented, you learned how to update a legacy contact on Facebook. You also learned a little bit about joincake.com. You learned that it wasn't about making cakes, eating cakes, or anything dealing with a cake. It's strictly the largest online end-of-life platform on the internet. 30 million views a year. I think you can trust this website. I know I do. And I hope this little video helps you a lot. Till next time, have a great day.